वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी पार्ट 3 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 12, दैट इज सिंपल मशीन्स. वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड विद सम ऑफ द सिंपल मशीन्स लाइक इंक्लाइंड प्लेन. वी हैव सीन वेज, वी हैव सीन लिवर इट्स टाइप्स. आई टोल्ड यू टू रिमेंबर द वर्ड फ्ली, FLE. होप यू मस्ट हैव रिमेंबर्ड दैट वर्ड. वॉट इज दैट वर्ड? FLE. F stands for fulcrum, L stands for load, and E stands for effort. These are the three main parts of the lever, and according to that only there are three types of the levers also. You can give this flea as numbers 1, 2, and 3. If fulcrum is in between, it is a first order lever. If load is in between, it is a second order lever. If effort is in between, it is a third order lever. Like this also you can remember these three parts of the lever with the three types. Is it okay, children? So here in the, before starting with the some of the other simple machines like pulley and wheel and an axle, here are the some machines given to you all, children. They are asking some machines we use in our day-to-day life. What is the type of lever in each of them? Like this first machine is a wheelbarrow. Second one is this a plier, this scissor, seesaw. So you have to identify the type of lever. If the fulcrum is in between, it will be the first order lever. If load is in between, it is second order lever. And effort is in between, it is a third order lever. So hope you can identify these types of lever. Now today, let us start with the another simple machine, that is pulley. So let us start with the pulley. Okay, here you require some things, like you require a pencil, some tape to stick that pencil on a table, empty reel of thread. See, can you see this empty reel? Like this reel of thread you have to take. You have to take a thick thread to tie on this reel. Weight, such an eraser. To tie it to the one end of the thread, you have to take one eraser. That can be tied to the thread, and you have to take a play dough. The children are playing with the dough, no? Making some shapes and all. So all these things you require for doing this. Now what you have to do, children, you have to take that pencil, you have to fix it on a table properly to the one of the edge of the table. You have to take a pencil, you have to jut it properly to the one of to the edge of the table. Fix it firmly. How you will fix that pencil? With the help of a sticking tape. That plastic tape is there, no? You have to fix it with that tape. Then after that, suppose this above one is a pencil, you have fixed it tightly to the table with the help of tape. Then you have to take this reel. Okay, this reel you have to insert it properly over that part of pencil. Put a lump of Play-Doh on the tip of the pencil so that the reel does not come off. You can fix this with the help of a dough. How they have inserted like this, you can put it with the help of a dough, so that the reel does not come out. Then you have to take this thread. Can you see this thread? This thread is drawn from here. It is put from that reel like this. And to the one end, they have tied this eraser. And to the other end, you have to pull it. So children, what happens when this is a loose end, and here you have tied the weight. Okay, weight means you have taken one eraser. Okay, children. So what happens when you pull from here downwards? If you pull, what happens? This weight will go up. The weight tied at the other end gets lifted up. This is the work of the pulley. This is the work of the pulley. Understood, children? Such a device with a grooved wheel. Children, can you see? This is a wheel. Okay, when you tie a thread on this, what happens? And you tie one weight to the other end, what happens? The weight gets lifted up if you pull it from the downward direction. So such a device with a grooved wheel, this is a wheel and thread is designed to lift the weight. Such a machine is called as a simple machine is called as a pulley. What it is called? Pulley. Sorry. Such a device with a grooved wheel, because in this wheel there is a place from where the thread can pass, and here other end we can put tie the weight, and from this end we can pull it in downward direction so that the weight gets lifted up. Such a design is called as a pulley. Now children, how does this help to use a pulley? If you use a pulley, force can be applied in downward direction. Children, you pull the thread from one end downward, then the other end of the thread, the weight is get lifted in upward direction. That means you apply a force in the downward direction and the weight is lifted in the upward direction. Yes or no? This eraser will get lifted up and from here you have to pull down. Yes or no? So this is convenient and easy. You must have seen such examples of pulley in day-to-day use. Like example, you can give in the villages. Children, you must have seen the well. To pull the water from a well, pulley is designed. Yes or no? On the well, the top, the pulley is fitted. On that pulley, the thread is applied. Thread is put. On the other end, one end of the thread, the bucket is fitted. And from one end, the person is pulling it to get the water. So, example is that pulling water from a well. Example of pulley. So, here we have seen the pulley. Pulley is a simple machine which helps us to pull up the things. Even the construction sites, you must have seen the pulley to lift the cements, cement which they are dipping in water. Like that, they are using to pull it up to the construction site. Next one is wheel and axle. Next simple machine which we are going to see after pulley is a wheel and an axle. Children, all of you must have enjoyed a giant wheel. See this in the fairs, you must have seen this giant wheel. Yes or no, children? What makes this giant wheel to go round? You know, children, this wheel goes on rotating. The giant wheel is fitted to a rod at its center. Can you see there is a rod in the center? Yes or no, children? This rod is nothing but it is called as an axle. And this rod is called as an axle and this is called as a wheel. Okay, children, when the axle starts rotating, first this axle will move with the help of electricity. The wheel fitted it also starts rotating. First this axle will start rotating, then this wheel will start rotating. This combination of an axle and a wheel is a simple machine. Understood, children? We see such innumerable examples its use. Even here you can see of a bullock cart. Yes or no, children? In between there is a bullock cart wheel. You must have seen in the villages the bullock cart wheel. Okay, children, it is also round in shape. In between it is having one rod like structure, that is the axle, and this wheel starts rotating. Okay, and similarly when the pedal of a bicycle is rotated, the wheel also starts rotating. Understood, children? So this is also a simple machine, wheel and a axle. Now children, here we have completed all the simple machines in this chapter. We have seen about inclined plane, we have seen about wedge, pointed when two inclined planes are joined, a sharp tool is formed, that is a wedge, knife, chisel. We have seen its example. We have seen lever. Lever consists of three parts: fulcrum, effort and load. Even we have seen its three orders. I have given you the word FLE. Okay, F stands for fulcrum, L stands for load, E stands for effort, and I have given you the number also, 1, 2, 3 down. 1 means if fulcrum is in between, it is a first order lever. If load is in between, it is a second order lever. If effort is in between, it is a third order lever. Then we have seen the pulley, examples of pulley in day-to-day life, and we have seen the wheel and axle. Now last part of the machine is maintenance of machines. Children, we are using machines. Maybe there are simple machines or complex machines, but we have to maintain them. Yes or no, children? Any vehicle in your house, if you do not maintain, if you do not give servicing to that proper service to that vehicle, will that vehicle will run smoothly? No. So that means you have to maintain all the machines. Parts of machines rub against one another when they are used. Children, what happen inside that minute parts are there, they always rub against one another when we are continuously using. Sometimes soil, dusty parts create more friction. So due to that, what happens, the some parts get due to the weather, sometimes it gets rusted. Okay, they get eroded, the machines get damaged due to the continuous use, due to soil, dust settle on it. Due to the weather also, sometimes what happens, the machines gets damaged. So to machines, to prevent, to avoid this, it is very important to take care of machines. And if you don't maintain them, if you don't repair it, what happens, the machines will not work. So during the maintenance of machines, all its parts are wiped clean. Children, what is done? First of all, the machine's parts are cleaned properly. Oil or lubricant is released between the parts that rub against one another. Children, oil is put again to some of the parts so that there is a less friction. If there is more friction, what happens, the parts will not work properly. So to avoid it, to avoid more friction, oil is put between the some parts. Okay, machines are covered when not in use to prevent dust. Children, one thing to avoid thus settling on them. We should cover the machine when it is not in use to prevent effect of weather. Metallic parts in a machine are painted. Children, due to the weather, what happens? Sometimes the rust is seen on the machine. To avoid this, machines are painted and the machines are always kept dry. You should not keep it in a water. Understood? So these are the things which we can do. We can oil it. We can oil to prevent the friction. We can cover the machines to avoid dust settling on it. To we can paint the machines if the machine is getting affected due to the weather. And we always should take care of the machines if we have to repair it time to time. So always remember, if machines are not properly maintained, they will be of no use, children. Before we use a machine, we must learn how to handle it properly so that there are no accidents. Children, whenever we are trying something new, you should be trained in that. So whenever you are handling any machine, you should handle it properly so that no accidents should take place, no injury should happen. So these are the things which you should remember. So here we have learned about some simple machines, complex machines, its examples. Okay, some simple machines we have learned, like inclined plane, pulley, wheel and axle, wedge, reliever, its types and care of machines. So here we ended the chapter. In the next part, I will upload all the question answers. So I hope you understood the lesson. As I uploaded the videos part by part, please go through the textbook also properly. Till then, goodbye.